Hello everyone, welcome back to Unite Coaching. We had uploaded a video on how to prepare for MPSC Civil Engineering Mains examination, and we had given an expected cutoff for 2018 and 2019 pre-examination. We are proud to say you that for both the years our predicted cutoff for the MPSC Civil Engineering preliminary examination was correct, and that video was liked by many of you, so thank you very much for that. And please keep supporting our work like this. Now coming back to this video, in this video we are going to tell you how to crack any competitive civil engineering exam very easily. The exams such as MPSC, SSC JE, GATE, departmental exams like PWD, WRD, WCD, CIDCO or any other exam like this. So the first thing you should decide in which exam are you preparing for, or which exam are you preparing for, whether it is ESE, that is UPSC Engineering Services, whether it is PSUs Public Sector, whether it is MPSC, SSC JE, or whether it is departmental exam like PWD, WRD, WCD, CIDCO, etc. So first decide your target. Why I am saying this? Because every exam has different pattern. For example, if you want to appear for ESE and SSC JE, that is UPSC and SSC JE, then it has pre as well as mains exam, and the mains exam is descriptive type here. Whereas if you are preparing for MPSC, then for both the exams, that is pre and mains, the questions are objective type. So you will have to study and practice according to the pattern of the exam, and always target for the big and better exams like GATE, ESE and MPSC, and especially for those exams which are generally taken every year. This is because if you are preparing for big exams, and even if you are not qualified in these exams, you will surely or easily crack any other exam such as departmental exams. So once your target is finalized, start collecting all the notes for it. And before starting the preparation for any exam, you must be ready with all the notes you need. So which notes you should refer? I always say in my video that I personally believe you should refer postal study material of famous engineering classes. For example, if you are preparing for GATE or UPSC or any state level exam, then you should refer these books or these notes. I have ranked them as first, the IAS Master Delhi Notes, Postal Study Material. Second is the MADEASY, and third is ACE Academy Notes. And I am not saying that other notes are not very good. I am just giving my point of view that these notes are quite good for your study. And this Postal Study Material or Postal Study course should cover all the civil engineering subjects as well as non-technical stuff like aptitude, reasoning, current affairs and general studies. If you still can't find any one or maximum two subjects, you can buy a reference book for that. But in my opinion, you will not need any extra books because all the notes are covered in this postal study material only. Now the next thing is find and print as many as previous year question papers for the exam you are preparing. When you go through such papers, you will observe that many questions are either getting repeated or they are asked on the same concept and they are repeated many times. This will be very helpful in knowing the pattern of the exam, type of questions they are asking, whether it is more numerical based or whether it is more theoretical based questions, and on which subject they are focusing very much. Then you can study accordingly. For example, in GATE exam, the questions, many questions are very formula based or they are numerical type. In MPSC, they ask both numerical as well as theoretical questions, and they are 2-2 marks for in the main examination. Whereas in departmental exams, you must also be very good in non-technical subjects such as English, Marathi, aptitude, general studies, history, geography, economics. All these subjects you should also prepare for, especially for departmental exams, because they carry more marks in departmental exams. You cannot crack just by preparing only civil engineering subjects in this exam. Now, the next thing is that what are the do's and don'ts and what are the strategies that you should have? First, do not directly start practicing the MCQs. Many students just take a random book and starts reading or solving the MCQs. That's very wrong way. You should first study the theoretical part of that, and then only, if you are confident that I have covered all the theoretical part of it, then you should go for the MCQs. And you can even skip some of the part of your syllabus. It is not necessary to cover all and each and every single part of your syllabus. But just keep in mind that you have to at least cover maximum of the syllabus. And remember one thing, preparing for the MPSC or any competitive exam or UPSC or any SSC exam is about what to study. It's more like what to study and what not to study. So you should also focus which points you have to study very, which points are very important and which parts you can skip, or some of the bits you can skip. Next thing is that keep in mind you need at least 6 to 10 months of dedication for cracking any exam. So keep in mind that I will study or I will give my 100% for my studies, and you form a routine for your studies, follow it properly, try to give minimum 4 hours for study, that is 4 hours completely for the study and 1 to 2 hours for the revision of what you have studied in the previous days, and 1 to 2 hours for solving MCQs on the topics which you think you now are studied properly, and also give some time for the formulas, make a small handout of the formulas and read it at least a week, means you have to repeat those formulas, write it down weekly, at least weekly. So in total you have to daily study at least 6 to 8 hours and very dedicatedly for 6 to 10 months. Now the next thing, when you are simultaneously revising the things which you have already studied, try solving the MCQs and try to observe where you are exactly lacking and make it better on the same day itself. For example, if you are not good in some of the topics of geotechnical engineering, if you think that these formulas I am not remembering it properly, try to revise it on the same day itself and make it habitual of it. Now next thing is that make a list of subjects you have to study, means you have to divide the subject according to their difficulty level, the subjects which are more difficult, which are less difficult and which are very easy. You have to divide it accordingly. I have also given name of subjects which are more difficult, which are medium level difficult and which are easy in my previous video of how to prepare for MPSC civil engineering mains. You can watch that video also. And divide also the subjects according to their maximum and minimum marks. For example, subject like geotechnical engineering, environmental engineering, highway engineering, structural engineering, structural subjects, SOM, etc. They will require more time and practice, but they are also very important from marks point of view. Whereas subjects like CPM, tunnel, bridge, estimating costing valuation, they will require less marks, less time for its preparation. But in some of the exams, they are not even asked for 2 marks also. So try to separate these subjects. Now next thing, I always say that prepare a diary of the notes and try to note important points, important formulas in a very short way, and try to fit all the subjects in the same diary itself if possible. Now next thing, don't just study the technical subjects only. It is equally important that you should also give time for the non-technical subjects like aptitude, reasoning, English, Marathi, general studies, which includes history, geography, economics, politics, sports, current affairs. You should also give time for these topics also and these subjects also. Especially in the department level exams, it carry more marks and you cannot crack that exam only by just studying the civil engineering subjects. Now, in your last days of preparation, purchase the mock test series of famous engineering classes. Start giving mock tests of various subjects, subject wise mock tests, as well as full subject or full syllabus wise mock tests, and try to observe where you are lacking in a particular subject and prepare that subject or prepare that or rectify that mistake on the same day itself. And at last, Always remember that your competition is only you and no one else, and be positive all the times. And you think that you will definitely crack the exam, and you will surely crack the exam. I have seen many students who were not very good in their studies during their academics, but they cracked the competitive exams just with their consistency, dedication and hard work. So be consistent, be dedicated and be a hard working, and you will easily crack any exam. So hope you like this video. Best of luck for your exams, and comment "yes, I will crack the exam" if you think that you can crack the exam. And please subscribe to Unite Coaching for more such videos. Thank you very much.